Howdy! In this lesson, we're going to be looking at the fundamental equation of the finite wings theory and applying specifically an elliptical lift distribution to that, which means that we are going to be assuming a value of gamma and then seeing what comes out of this equation. So, an elliptical lift distribution means that we're going to have a value of gamma which is equal to gamma naught times the square root of 1 minus 2y over b squared. So this is a distribution that varies smoothly from 0 on either side, from both b over 2 and negative b over 2, and is gamma naught in the center. So the tricky part about plugging this in is that our upwash is, or downwash, is actually dependent on our elliptical lift distribution. So this means that we need to find the derivative of gamma, which is what this depends on. So d gamma by dy is going to be equal to this constant gamma naught, and then we need to start stepping through the chain rule. So first off, we have a 1/2 from the square root, and this means that we're also going to be multiplying by a 1 minus 2y over b squared to the negative 1/2. Going in, we're going to have a negative sign, so we can put that out front. We're going to have a 2 from the squared, and that means that we also need to multiply by our 2y over b. And then finally, our final step is to multiply by just the 2 over b from inside the squared. All right, so that's a lot of terms. First off, these guys can cancel out, and we're going to be left with a negative gamma naught times 4y all over b squared. And this is going to be multiplied by 1 minus 2y over b squared to the negative 1/2. Okay, so now we can go ahead and plug this in our w. So our w term, w of y naught, is going to be equal to negative 1 over 4 pi times the integral from negative b over 2 to b over 2 times d gamma by dy all over y naught minus y integrated over y. So if you remember, our downwash is due to these trailing vortices, which have strength based on the variation of our bound vortex. And in each of these, we're interested in the distance from those vortices to the point y naught, where we're actually measuring the downwash. So let's go ahead and plug in our d gamma dy term. So first off, the 4s are going to cancel out, and the negatives are going to cancel out. And so we're going to be left with, as constants outside of the integral, just a gamma naught over pi b squared. And then the integral from negative b over 2 to b over 2, this y comes inside. And then the y naught minus y continues over. And then we're going to have a dy term divided by this square root. So this is going to be square root of 1 minus 2y over b, and all that squared. Now, in order to integrate this, first off, we need to make a substitution. And the substitution we're going to make is y being equal to negative b over 2 times cosine of theta. And then whenever we take the derivative to find dy, this becomes a b over 2 times sine of theta times d theta. Alright, so now that we have that, we can go ahead and plug all these in, and this becomes a gamma naught over pi times b squared, integrating, and we substitute in our theta values where our y values once were. So theta is equal to 0 to get y equal to negative b over 2. So we're integrating from 0 to pi. And then we substitute in y here as well, and both the numerator and the denominator. So the b over 2 and the negative signs cancel out, and so we're left with a cosine of theta over cosine of theta naught minus cosine of theta. And all of this is going to be multiplied by our substituted dy, which is a b over 2 sine theta times d theta. And then whenever we substitute in y here, we end up with a square root of 1 minus cosine squared theta. Now this, of course, becomes a sine squared theta, which once you take the square root, this becomes just a sine theta. So this term and this term actually cancel out. And so to simplify, we can say that this becomes a gamma naught over 2 pi b, where this b cancels out here, and then the 2 goes to the denominator. And this is times the integral from 0 to pi of a negative cosine theta all over cosine theta minus cosine of theta naught. So basically, I just switched the order here to bring a negative out front. And the reason I did that is because we know what the integral of this integrand is. And this entire thing is simply going to be negative pi. So this means that the downwash at a given y naught location is going to be a negative gamma naught over 2b. Now this is exciting because this is not actually a function of y naught. This is a constant. So this means that for the special case where our lift is defined by an elliptic distribution, the downwash is constant over the entire wing. And so we can say that W is a constant based on